Hi guys, and happy Friday. So today is starting something really cool with my friends over on Instagram, which is a 10 by 10 challenge. My friend Lee Vosberg actually created this challenge. So I wanted to show each piece that I picked out to create 10 different outfits. The idea is you take 10 pieces, create 10 outfits over 10 days. It's to challenge yourself, to try to be more creative with your wardrobe. And I just love that idea. It's like a mini capsule wardrobe. It's also great if you're going to be traveling or if you just need to start over for the season on your wardrobe. So let's get started. I'm gonna talk through all 10 outfits and all 10 pieces. So what's included with it is tops, bottoms, shoes, sweaters, coats, and dresses. So anything like an accessory, a hat, underwear, anything like that is just not included, and you can wear as many of those things as you want to or need to. So for the first outfit, I wanted to have something that was a white on white look. I've been really into monochrome lately, and just having white on white is going to allow for a lot more outfit combos as the 10 days go on. So this top is not exactly like a very white white, but it's more like an ivory. And it's this lovely crochet knit top that I got from And Other Stories. They were having a really big sale, so I allowed myself to just try out this new brand, and so this was one of the first pieces that I got from them. I love it because of that it's still very light and breathable because it's a crochet knit, so it's very like loose, but it's still a sweater, which is kind of nice if you're cold natured or inside a lot during summertime. So that's definitely me. I could definitely use as much warmth as I can with still a summer look. I like to wear nippies with it or a bra, like a nude bra, but you also could wear a cami under it just depending on like circumstances and all that and how you feel. And then the bottoms are my Everlane cheeky jeans that I just love so much. I've talked at length about these on my channel already and I wear them all the time. So I will leave it kind of briefly that I got them hemmed and I just love the high rise on them. Everlane is one of my favorite companies, so anytime I can find a good pair of jeans from them or just anything from them, I'm just obsessed. So for this look, I liked the look of having a day heel with this. So this is an Everlane day heel in a suede, more of like a muted gray taupe color that's maybe even a bit like an ivory. And so this whole look just looks very like monochrome and minimal and very chic, and that's what I was going for. For jewelry with this look, you guys know how I love to wear gold jewelry, so what I layered with this is the Pamela Card Rosetta necklace, as well as the Nakia from her as well, and then the Aphrodite, which is here. All three of them together just create a really lovely, cohesive gold jewelry look that's amazing. I did choose to wear one bracelet in this, which is this one from Cold Picnic. It's a braided, lovely gold bangle that I just like to throw on, and it has still a minimal look and it still goes together with everything else. So I'm wearing this with each look out of the 10 days. Another brand that is very new to me that I have been loving wearing is Sisterhood. I reached out to them a little while ago and they were able to get me a few things to try them out, and I'm just so happy so far with this brand because they're so much more affordable than a lot of the other brands that I wear, but yet the quality and how beautifully chic they are and timeless each piece is just so incredible. I wanted to wear this slip dress because it's one of my favorite things in my closet right now. I like to be able to wear this in different ways, but honestly, it is beautiful on its own. It's a beautiful slip dress. It, you know, obviously looks a lot like a slip, only it is double lined and it's got this beautiful floral pattern on it. And the buttons are, there's probably a special term for this type of button, but they're very secure and like still very feminine and dainty. Also, I liked it because you can really adjust this to fit yourself. They've got the adjustable straps here, and then it's also got this waist tie that allows me to be able to wear it a little bit tighter at times or however I feel comfortable. So I ended up wearing the day heels again. As a reminder, this counts as one of my items, so I will be wearing like repeat shoes a lot, but I've been so happy with these because they match just anything, and this still gives such a put together, classy look to a slip dress. Like, the whole look just elevates the style with a nice pair of shoes. So for this outfit, I wore the exact same jewelry as I did for the first look. For the third look, I'm actually wearing another sisterhood piece. So this is the Gwen blouse. I had to include this one with my 10 looks because I could dress this up in so many different ways. I could wear this on a date night, or I could wear it to the office. I think that it's one of the most versatile tops that I have. So I had to include it for this 10 by 10 challenge. And I also like that it's a bit of a statement look with the ruffles. It's also a wrap top, so you can just kind of tie it to where it fits best on you, which is really cool. I also like that it has long sleeves that are just beautifully made, and it has these little buttons on it, again, just like the slip dress. So I had to include jeans in my 10 by 10 challenge, of course. So the jeans that I went with are my Jessie Cans. I love the look of these because they're very unique. It's not too boring, like, you know, wearing another pair of jeans this week. Like, these are more statement jeans, and they spice up the 10 outfits. So yeah, I just had to go with my Jessie Cam sailor pants. These ones are so incredibly comfortable too, so I can wear them sitting down really comfortably. So I will link this along with all of the different things down below in the description, but these jeans are more of like a statement piece, and they're very much of an investment piece. So I love them, and I always look back and think, wow, I love that outfit. So that's why I took the splurge and got these ones, but I can link some down below for you guys as well for like more affordable options. So again, I'm wearing the same jewelry and the same shoes. So this next outfit, number 4, is beautiful for summertime. It's just a pair of shorts and a cami, but I love these pieces so much. So this is an Everlane silk cami, and I love that it's got like more of a V-neck almost, and I also like that I can just tuck this in. Silk is just very light and breathable, great for summertime. And great to layer too. Like, you could wear this easily underneath the crochet top I talked about earlier. And for the shorts, again, I'm going with Jessie Cam. These, I was just talking today about how out of all of the shorts that I've tried, these ones just feel the most flattering on me. And so that's why I'm really happy that I have them. This one is in the color Tobacco, which I don't believe she makes anymore, but I'll try to hunt down on Etsy or something and find a place that has, you know, a copy of this pair of shorts or something similar to it. So my other pair of shoes for all 10 days is the Nasolo Palomas. Now, I love these ones so much because it's a mule. It's very comfortable here on the ball of my foot. It's got extra cushioning. Right now, these are on their like final sale of summertime, so you can get them on sale real good and cheap. So definitely check that out. I think it ends very soon, and I also have a discount that I mentioned in my last video, which is Dearly 10. That'll get you 10% off through tonight, so it's almost done until Friday at 11:59 Central Time, I believe. So again, for jewelry, I'm just wearing the same 3 pieces. You know, I don't need to necessarily switch out each jewelry piece, but there were just a couple times that I felt different outfits needed a different look. For the next outfit, I wanted to wear a shirt that I think I could pair with anything, any pair of pants, even the dress. So this top I just love so much. It's one of my new favorite tops. This one's from And Other Stories, and it's just a scoop neck that is in this beautiful, like, muted pink color. I also like that I went with a bit of a looser fit, so definitely try to do that if you can or if you want to, depending on your own personal taste. But I like that it's kind of like a relaxed fit and that it's a little bit drapey in the material that it's made out of. So I ended up wearing this shirt with my Everlane jeans again. Overall, this whole look gave more of like a minimal chic look that was really lovely. And to give even more of a minimal chic look, I went with the day heels again. As for jewelry with this outfit, I wanted a bit of a shorter necklace, so I swapped out the Pamela Card Aphrodite necklace and I went with this one that is just like a little bit cheaper coin necklace from Etsy. So for this next look, this is where a lot of mixing and matching is going to start happening. So I went with my And Other Stories crochet top and I mixed that with my pair of jeans from Jessie Cam. So this whole look gives like a very Americana feel, but then I dressed it up with my Everlane day heels. As for jewelry, I went back to the long necklace, the Aphrodite, and then I also had my Nakia and Rosetta necklaces. Sorry guys, the sun's going down and hopefully not a lot of lighting change actually is showing up right now. So for the next look, I again went with this scoop neck top and I wanted to wear some really nice and light shorts with them. So I went with the Jessie Cam shorts again, which gave this whole look a very like rustic vintage color scheme and I just loved that. So for shoes with this, I went with my Nisolo Palomas that just really gave the same look as the color of the shorts. So again, the jewelry was on repeat with this. I just like the look of a shorter necklace with this top. So outfit number 8, I wore this top again, but this time was in such a different way that I just really loved it. So these little pink hues that are in this shirt actually brought out a lot of the pink tones in my sisterhood slip dress. And so together they just paired really well. I've tried a lot of other tops to go under or over this slip dress, but this one was the perfect one. And together they just create a beautiful outfit and a great, great two pieces for a 10 by 10 challenge. As for shoes, this outfit was just very cute. It felt like almost what you would wear to a nice brunch or tea party or something. So I definitely wanted to go with the day heels again for this look. For the jewelry, I am wearing the longer necklace here with the other two, the Rosetta and the Nakia. But I just like had it tucked in a little bit. So the longer necklace really was something that I could still wear and just have kind of subtly there. So another very chic all white outfit for this summer. I've been wearing so many of these outfits, all one color. Just that's what I've been wearing this season and it's been really fun. So this outfit is a cami, my white cami from Everlane with the Everlane cheeky jeans. So this is a really great look. I love to wear silk and these white jeans are just so perfect for summer. So together they just make a really good outfit and great for this 10 by 10. As for shoes, I went with the day heels. So that just kind of pulls the whole outfit together very well. I honestly could have worn the Palomas too, but I liked the look of this one a little bit more. And then I went with the longer necklace look that just gave a little bit more of like a feminine look and just made the neckline just really beautiful. For the final outfit, I had to wear my sisterhood shirt again. The ruffles on this were even a little bit of a contradiction to how I wore them with this last outfit, which was with the Jessie Cam shorts. So these are very like, you know, a little bit boyish. They're cut offs. They're very vintage and give just such a really great rustic vibe. But then at the same time, I'm wearing something that's very feminine, has beautiful ruffles on it, and together they could be dressed up or dressed down. Like this outfit would just be really great for summertime doing almost anything. So I definitely wanted the longer necklace for this top because it just naturally lends itself to having longer necklaces with the way that the neckline is. And then to dress up this outfit a little bit more, I went with the day heels again. I really liked that the day heel really matched the top very well, drew that whole outfit together through just this look. So those were the 10 outfits, but I actually combined about 14 different looks out of all of these pieces, just these 10 pieces. So that's just proof that with a little bit of creativity, you can create half a month's worth of looks out of just 10 pieces. And that's what this challenge is all about, is just inventing creativity into your wardrobe, seeing how you can make new outfits, maybe see pieces in ways that you haven't tried before. So that's just really cool. And I think it's a really great idea. Also, my friend Caroline is a part of this 10 by 10 challenge. And she and Lee actually do this together like every season and just kind of share their looks. So definitely check out Caroline's as well. I'll leave her links down below. And definitely check out the 10 by 10 challenge hashtag. So I'll link that down below as well. Hopefully you guys have created some really great looks. I'd love to be able to see them. So write in the comments if you're going to be part of the 10 by 10 challenge at all. And maybe if you're gonna share it online, definitely tell me like what your Instagram handle is so that I can check it out. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.